I hope you're ready. Here's a fun new node in Houdini 19.
Curve 2.0. Who doesn't love creating curves? We use them all the time in our work, whether it be for creating custom branches that we can add some flowers onto, or maybe you're just making a logo. But in Houdini 19, we got some really sweet upgrades, making the curve tool super fun to use. Let's dive in and check it out. If you pop open the help page of the curve node, you'll quickly realize that this tool is packed with so many new features. So I'm not going to show all the features, but be sure to check out the help page as it's awesome. But here are some of my favorite features. Let's start in an empty scene. We'll drop a curve node. We can hit enter and we can start adding points. If you just click, it'll create points. But if you click and drag, you get some really nice bezier curves. If you have a curved line and you want to draw a straight line, you can hold control and shift and it'll let you draw a straight line. You can also hold down control and click and drag, and this will draw out a tangent handle. This also works when you add your first point. You can click and drag to create the tangent handle, no need to hold control. If you place a point and hold A, you can make some nice arcs with matching tangent handles. Once you have a curve in place that you're happy with, you can change it from draw mode to edit mode. The keyboard shortcuts for this are F, G, and H. In edit mode, you can just click and move points around. If you hold control and click a point, it'll move the tangent handle and not just the point. You can also click on the curve itself to manipulate the tangent curve. You can use the 1, 2, and 3 keys to change the type of tangent handles. 1 separates the handles, 2 joins them, and 3 equalizes the handles to one another. You can also hold control and move tangent handles to move them independently of its neighbor. When moving points around, you often want to move it in a specific axis. Then you can enable the transform axis handle by pushing K. Holding shift will move your entire curve. Split or cutting a point will duplicate the point, opening your curve. Likewise, you can select 2 points and join them with the join tool. One of my most loved new features is the ability to add round corners to curves. Select a point, click round edges, and you can now drag the little inner dot to make some nice round corners. If your curve gets this weird geometry, you can right click and say close curve. So with that in mind, let's use these tools to create an amazing 2D logo. Let's hover over our viewport and hit D. This will open up a menu. We can go to the background tab and choose the front. We'll grab a reference image from Google. You don't even have to download it. You can just paste the URL into the file slot. Let's turn down the brightness. We'll jump into our front view by pressing space 3. We can now start drawing out our curve. It doesn't have to be exact, as we can also edit the points afterwards. I'm going to start with the straight edges, as I find these are the easiest to draw. By holding shift, I can constrain the lines to a straight edge. Now I just click and drag to get some nice bezier curves. Now we have a closed curve. If you want the curve to be open so you can see through it while you're manipulating the points, you can just right click on any of the points and split the curve or cut the point. This will now open your curve and duplicate the points at where you cut it. Now I can select those 2 points again and I can click the join to make this a solid curve once again. Now I'll just quickly go through and do the D again. I hit the G mode to start drawing, and once I've finished drawing my shapes, I can hit F to clean up the curves and manipulate them and edit them as I see fit. Now our points are all still bezier, so we can convert them using a convert node. The U value will act like a resample where it'll add more or less points. The main difference between resampling and using a convert is that a convert will try and maintain the shape of the original object while adaptively placing points, which is similar to the resample set to resample by polygon edge. The default resample will uniformly place points around the object, oftentimes distorting our original shape. You can now also work directly on the font sop. This is great if you want to bring in a font and then just make some small alterations. So make sure that your font is set to output beziers only. Then you can use a convert node to set the bezier curve. This just sets the U order correctly. Then drop down a curve and you can start adjusting. A cool trick is to sweep the curve sop, as the sweep can sweep bezier curves. You can then convert it after the sweep to get some nice control. We can also do some cool things where we create some curves, move them around, and turn them into vellum hair. Let's draw some curves and we'll move them around in 3D space so that some are overlapping one another. We can then use a copy and transform to make more copies and just adjust some of the parameters. We can then resample them. Now we want to create point groups on either end of the curve that we can pin in vellum. We can use the group expression set to first point of primitive to get the root or first point of each curve. But how do we get the second? If we go back into our resample and we enable the curve view attribute on the resample node, we get an attribute that runs from 0 to 1 across each curve. This means that our last point will always have a value of 1. We can use this in a group node to fetch the last point. Now we have the first and last point, and no matter where we move these lines or how long or short they are or how many points, these groups remain intact. In the vellum hair node, we can pin these points. Let's reduce the stiffness, increase the bend. We'll also increase the edge length scale. Let's add a tube as a collider and feed it into the vellum solver with 4 sub-steps. Now post-sim, we can resample, clean, and sweep. Amazing. Obviously, this tool can do all sorts of amazing things. Now with Houdini 19, it's only much easier and more fun to make curves. So why don't you give it a try? You know what time it is, Houdini time.